Let's establish something right up front. I really like Syma's quadcopters. I mean, the second quadcopter I ever owned was a Syma X11. Then I got the Syma X5C-1. Then I got the X8G. So, yeah, I'm a fan of Syma's quadcopters. Those are all great quads, and I still fly each one of them to this day, and they still perform very, very well. So, needless to say, I have pretty high expectations for this new Syma X5UW. I mean, we'll see if it lives up to my expectations, but my first impression, I mean, this thing looks amazing. Check out the controller. I mean, this looks sweet. We're talking about some serious aesthetic upgrades. So if you think about it, like the X5C is classic base model, solid Honda Accord, right? Well, you've got the X5UW. This one's the fully loaded model. Power locks, power windows, power steering. It's got leather interior, moonroof. It's got a shiny paint job. It's chromed out. Obviously, it's not real chrome, but you get the point. So, based on prior experience, I expect this thing to perform just as good as it looks. This thing is pretty, man. Oh, I forgot the smell test. Yeah. All right, we still gotta see how it flies, but it's looking good. It's looking good, baby. It's pretty much ready to fly right out of the box, but the only thing that you have to install is the phone clip. But other than that, you're ready to go. Absolutely everything you need is in that box. Except for the four AA batteries. That's all you have to supply, and you're ready to go. Okay, now it also comes with a instructions manual, which is laid out really, really well. So if you're a beginner, you're brand new to quadcopters, I highly recommend going through this. This thing comes with altitude hold. It's got Wi-Fi FPV, auto takeoff, auto land. What else does it have? It has a 720p camera. That takes photos and video, headless mode and the usual flips and stuff. So this thing is packed with features. It also has a feature on the Syma Go app that allows you to draw out a flight path, and this thing will follow the flight path. So if you draw a circle, it'll fly in a circle. If you draw a square, it'll fly in a square. And you can also fly this directly from the app. So we got a lot to cover. So let's go ahead and get this thing cracking. So let's take a quick look at everything we get in the box. Let's get everything set up properly. And then I'm gonna download the Syma Go app. And then we're gonna get outside and fly this thing, baby. I'm ready to fly. Let's go!
With a closer look at the controller, we can clearly see design cues from DJI's Phantom series. Looks really good to me. I really like the candy apple red chrome look. The upper left trigger button is how you are going to engage the video. The lower left trigger button is to take a photo. And then on the right side, the upper button is to auto take off and auto land. The lower right trigger button does flips. Clicking in the left throttle stick is how you would set your trims. Now I go through that in more detail in the flight test, so stay tuned. Now the right stick, when you push that in, you're going to change your rates. There's two rates, there's low and high. So you push that in. To engage headless mode, you're going to hold the stick button in for 3 seconds. On second thought, let's go ahead and take a look at how to set the trim. So you're going to hold down the left stick. Then you're going to move the right stick in the direction that you want to trim. So I'm giving it right trim there, right trim, left trim. There's forward trim and back trim. So it's a little bit of a funky way of doing it, but that's how it works. There's three ways to arm the motors. You can throttle up and then come back to center. Then the motors will start to spin. You can come to the inside corners and release. The motors will spin. Or you can hit the upper right trigger button. That's going to actually auto take off. This resets headless mode. Installing the phone holder is really simple. You just flip over the controller, remove this tab here, and then you're just going to take the phone holder and slide it right into that slot. Very, very simple. It clicks right in. Okay, Syma decided to go with a proprietary battery this time. Okay, so that might be unfortunate to some of us who have previous X5C models that might want to use our prior batteries. This one comes with two 3.7 volt 500 milliamp hour proprietary batteries. So the good thing about getting this package out on Amazon is it comes with two. So obviously that doubles your flight time. Depending on how you feel about the proprietary batteries, just note that you do get two. Now this is how you're going to go ahead and charge up the battery. There is an arrow on one side. That's how you know which side is up. And you just stick it in there, stick it into your PC or wall outlet. When that red light goes out, you know you're fully charged. We get an extra set of propellers. We get prop guards. We get a screwdriver. And we get a micro USB card reader. So you've got everything you need to film and upload to your computer. Here's the 720p 2 megapixel camera, which also comes with a 4 gigabyte micro SD card. Now one good thing about the proprietary batteries is it makes installing them very, very simple, very, very easy. All you want to do is just make sure you line up the side that has the slot and line it up with the slot in the quad and just push it in until you hear it click. Very, very simple. And to remove it, all you're going to do is push the slot on the bottom or the little tab on the bottom, squeeze it, pull it out, good to go. Okay, installing the camera is just as simple. All you're going to do is line up the plug, line up the grooves on the plug so that you put it in the right direction. You'll see the little notches on the actual plug there. So just line those up and pop it right in. Then you'll just have to position the camera just like so. And then turn it. And that will lock it in place. Just like you see me doing it here. Very, very simple. All right, y'all. Now it's flight time. So let's get to flight.
Here we go.
All right. Beautiful day in the neighborhood. What we're going to do first is we are going to fly the X5UW without the Wi-Fi just to see how it goes. It is a little bit windy today, and this is a light craft. So we'll see how it does in the wind. So let's go ahead and get it powered up. We're going to hold down the power button until we see the LEDs flash, which they are.
place it on the ground, up and then down to pair. Then we're going to go ahead and push the auto launch button. And in the air we go. Alright, that's the low rate. We're going to immediately go up to our high rate because, like I said, it is a little bit windy. So let's go into high rate. It is being pushed around just a little bit. But there we go. Altitude hold is engaged. Alright, I am going to give it a little bit of trim. So remember what you do is you push down the left stick and give it the input in the direction that you want. Let's try that again. Okay. Alright, let's go ahead and give it some altitude here. Bring it back so we can take a look at it. Back in the air. Okay. Go back to the high rate. As you can see, it is being pushed by that wind pretty good. Now this is with the wind. And right off the bat, I'm noticing that the altitude hold works perfectly. So you're not going to get a whole lot of pitch out of this, which is good because it allows it to maintain its altitude without driving into the ground. Now it is dipping there with the turn, but this quad is meant for capturing video and pictures. And when you have a quad that's meant for that, you want a stable platform. Alright, so with that said, let's go ahead and engage the video by pushing the upper left hand trigger button. And as you can see, the LEDs are blinking, which indicates we are capturing video. So let's go ahead and fly it around a little bit. Nice and smooth. This is with the wind. Not too bad. Alright, let's do a flip or two here. Wind still pushing it here. Here's the flip. Okay, it does lose a little bit of altitude when it flips, but the quad will regain altitude all by itself. And we're flying against the wind. Now we're coming back with the wind. And it's moving out. Okay. Let's bring it on back over here. This is a really, really smooth flying machine. Really good looking machine. Check it out. Very pretty. Very pretty machine. Okay, so let's give it a little bit of altitude here, not too high, but just enough to capture some footage. And again with the wind, and now we're going against the wind. That is full pitch there, and coming back full pitch with the wind. And as you can see, it does move pretty good. All right. So let's disengage the video camera now, and let's take some pictures. There's one. See if we can get it to get some momentum going. And there's another picture. And when you take a picture, the LEDs will blink once. There's another. Let's just fly it around. Comes roaring back with the wind there. flying real nice. Altitude hold works perfectly. No dips at all. It maintains its height perfectly. So this is a really good quadcopter for beginners. If you want something that's really deliberate when it flies, not super fast, this is the one you want to get. Something that a beginner can handle. I think this is a perfect gift for a beginner. Okay, so let's go ahead and try out the auto land feature by pushing the upper right hand button. And there we go. Auto land works perfectly. Now that's nice. Okay, let's relaunch. And the quad comes up, oh, about a meter or so. And just hovers. Very stable. Now the wind is pushing it, but it's holding its altitude really well. Let's keep it at about this height and fly it around and see if it holds its altitude. Yes, it does. Very nice. Now it is going to dip with the wind there. But very, very nice. Very, very nice. With turns, it will dip a little bit, but straight on, full pitch, it's holding its altitude as well as you would expect. Got to give it a little throttle there with the wind. All right, now headless mode. You engage headless mode by pushing and holding down the right trigger. I'm sorry, the right stick. All right, now the quadcopter, the LEDs will blink and the transmitter will beep for about 10 seconds to indicate it's in headless mode. So let's go ahead and yaw. So I am full yaw and the quadcopter is still responding as though the head or forward is still in front of us. So what I mean by that is, no matter which direction the quadcopter is facing, left is still left, right is still right, left is still left, right is still right, and back is still back, and forward is still forward. Okay, that works really, really well. I'm usually not a fan of headless mode because it usually doesn't work very well. But on this quadcopter, it works brilliantly. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and disengage headless mode now. And we're going to do that by holding down the right stick once again. All right, so you hear that long beep. The LEDs did flash once. We are now out of headless mode. So that's great. So again, if you are a beginner or you're buying this for a beginner, you want to get somebody into the hobby, into quadcopters, headless mode will allow them to get in the air and not worry about orientation. Okay, so we do have our LVC warning. Let's see, so the quad should start to auto land itself, which is what it's doing. And there we go. So I'm going to put the flight time up on the screen. What we're going to do now is we're going to go grab the smartphone, get this connected to Wi-Fi, and check out some Wi-Fi FPV. Alright, well, we're back out here for the Wi-Fi segment of the flight test. What we're going to do, we'll go ahead and power on the quad. Now, as you can see, I installed the prop guards, And very, very simple to do. Let me go ahead and get that paired. But very, very simple to do. Let me show you. They go right in here. There's a little button here that you pull or press, and you just push them right on in that slot. Okay, I'm making it harder than it is. There it is. Okay, and they go right in there. So I thought I'd go ahead and put them on. Since I'm thinking this is a really good starter quad for beginners, you want to go ahead and put the prop guards on. And since I'm going to be doing Wi-Fi here, just in case I run into anything, not a bad idea to have it installed already. So let's go ahead and put it on a flat surface here. As flat as I can get it. There we go. That looks good. Alright, now, here's the thing. I don't know if I mentioned this already, but when you go to get your app turned on and paired with the quad, you want to pair it to the controller first. That's the first thing you want to do. Okay, just like you were just going to fly with the controller itself. Then you're going to go and find the Wi-Fi signal. There it is. Okay, you got that connected. Now go over to the Syma Go app. And I'm going to go ahead and put it in here. And you just hit start. And as you can see, we do have a feed. Okay. Okay, so just a quick look at the app. As you can see right here, you can turn off the virtual sticks here. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave those on. Not real sure what that is, but I'm gonna leave it alone. This is to change your rates from low to high. I'm gonna put it in high right away. This, you can go and find your pictures and videos. This right here allows you to fly the quad with the accelerometer in your phone. So if you tilt it left, it'll fly left. Tilt it right, it'll fly right, forward, and back. Okay? I'm going to turn that off because we're going to fly normal. And this right here puts it in headless mode. This is your flight path where you can draw out a flight path for the quad to take, and it will fly that corresponding flight path, whatever you want to draw. I'm not going to demonstrate that today, but just to let you guys know that it is there. Okay? And you can take a picture from here and start the video from here. Okay, so when the app is engaged, you're not going to be able to use the trigger buttons, the top and bottom trigger buttons here, to engage video and photos. You're going to do that from the app. Okay, now, again, you can fly this just with the app, just from the app and not the controller. Now what you want to do, again, you want to follow those steps to pair it with the quad, pair the quad to the transmitter first, go into the app. If you want to fly just with the app, you'll then have to turn off the controller. Otherwise it won't work. And that goes for flight path as well, the track path here. You'll have to turn off the controller in order to use this. Okay, so keep that in mind. So yesterday was a little bit more of a windy day. Today there is virtually no wind, so we'll really see the actual performance of this quad. Like I said, it's so lightweight, it doesn't fight the wind that well. And now that we have the prop guards on as well, that would even work as a wind sail. So you want to fly these in no wind conditions or very little wind. Okay, so keep that in mind as well. Calibrating before every flight should reduce the need to trim the quad at all while it's flying. Okay, so I want to be super thorough with this review of this quad because I'm going to be recommending this and I'll probably be buying it for as a gift. So I want to be super thorough so I can just refer people to this video. So I'm going to demonstrate what happens when the quad loses connection with the transmitter. So you're flying around, you get out of distance, out of range, and you lose connection. What will happen? That's what we're testing here today. Okay, so let's go ahead and launch. Uh-oh. Didn't launch on a flat surface, so let's reset. And launch. All right. Okay. Take it over there. Okay, turning off the transmitter now. Okay, as you can see, it did auto land after about 2 or 3 seconds. I'll time that in the video. I'll put it up here somewhere. But I'd say that is a good fail safe. So if you're flying, like I said before, if you're flying and you fly out of range, it will land itself. It won't just keep going. Solid. Good job, Syma.
There you
go. We're going to go ahead and launch with the right trigger button here. I'm going to start the camera and get in the air. And we're going to do some Wi-Fi FPV right here from sitting on the deck here. And I tell you what, altitude hold is great for flying Wi-Fi FPV. Now that's just the low rate, so it's going to really prod along slowly. But you know what? That's awesome for getting camera footage or video footage or taking pictures. Look how slow it's moving. Let's bring it back over here. I mean, it's really moving really, really slow, but that's what you want. Look how stable that is. It is, the wind is blowing a little bit, but it's fighting that wind. It does want to drift that way. Okay, and I am recording, so I'll have that video up on the screen. But as you can see, I can see my, I can see the feed from my phone perfectly well. Let's just fly on out over there a little bit. And again, this is the low rate. Flying real nice and smooth. Alright. Very nice. I like this, man. Just sit on the porch and fly your quad. Get some video. You know, alright, here's what we're going to do now. We're going to go on up to the high rate, so we should be able to get a little more pitch. Now it's not, this one's not going to give you a whole lot of deep pitch. That's about all you're going to get, but it moves pretty good. Not slow. I wouldn't call it super fast or sporty, but I wouldn't call it slow either. Okay, this is a typical camera bird. This is a great one to start out with if you're just getting into the hobby. And, let's come on down. That wind is catching it a little bit, but it's handling it just fine. Again, I don't recommend flying this on a super windy day. Not a good idea. Okay, so it's flying around real nice. I'm liking it. And that feed is not breaking up. It's a little bit choppy, but you know, that's what you have to expect with Wi-Fi FPV. Now, what else do I want to say about this? Let's see. Real good. I'll have the flight time up on the screen here, so you guys can get an idea of how much flight time you get. And that's with it connected to the Wi-Fi app as well. And then I'll go ahead and do another flight without the Wi-Fi engaged, and we'll get an idea of what the flight time is that way as well. Flying real good. Let's bring it on back over. That altitude hold is awesome. I mean, this thing just looks like a Cadillac flying in the air, man. Like one of those old school cars, you know what I mean? There it is. Sweet looking quad, man. Really, really like the way that thing looks. All right. Little altitude here. It's flying real good. So solid altitude whole quad. And the Wi-Fi is working well. Working really well. Hopefully you guys can see this. Should be coming through just fine. And now this is recording right to the SD card. Okay, which is good because a lot of times with these Wi-Fi FPV quads, it's recording right to your phone, and that actually diminishes the quality of the video even more. Oh, that was one thing I wanted to mention about the video quality. Now, you can see for yourself, it's probably quite a bit of jello on this. It's not as bad when you're just hovering and remaining in kind of one spot, or, you know, making really slow, deliberate movements. But when you get up, you know, you start pitching forward fast or any direction fast, the jello kind of increases. I would imagine you could maybe reduce that by maybe balancing the props. I haven't done that. Or you could even put some foam underneath that camera to kind of kill some of the vibrations coming from the props. Pretty looking quadcopter. Pretty. So just judge the quality for yourself. You know, it is what it is. Look at that. Now the camera is removable as well. If you want to take it off, you can take the camera off. Does dip a little bit in that high rate when you're pitching forward fast, and in turns it will dip a little bit, so keep that in mind. Just manage your throttle, you'll be fine. What else? Okay, we've been filming for about 6.5 minutes here. I'm gonna go ahead and stop that camera, and so flight time is pretty good. I'd say about 8 minutes or so, but I'll get you the exact numbers. I'm gonna go ahead and take a picture. And another picture. This is fun, man. It's really fun. You know, so, and the best way to fly these things, especially if you're doing Wi-Fi FPV, is in an open area. Don't try to, you know, fly where there's a lot of obstacles and stuff. I mean, you're just asking for trouble. I mean, even if you're a good pilot. Okay, that's our flight time. All right, let's go and grab it. So I'll put the flight time up somewhere. I usually put my flight clock in the upper right-hand corner. So I'll probably do that again. All right. So I'll probably come back and do another video showing the night flight, showing the LEDs at night. But otherwise, we will call that a review. So as always, thanks for stopping by. Thanks for checking out my videos. If you're not a subscriber already, please consider doing so. Hit me with a like, share this with anybody you think might like it, and I'll talk to you guys in the next review. Later.